Good evening to all of you. In our last session, we have seen the introduction to C programming language. We have seen variable, constant, data types, keywords. Then we have also seen the different operators present in C programming language. All the input-output statements of C, that is printf and scanf. Then we have also seen the escape sequences in C programming language. So if you understood all those things, you can able to write a first C program in C programming language. Now the question for the first C program is, write a program to print hello in C programming language. So we'll write the code here. The first line in this program is hash include stdio.h. The next line is hash include conio.h. Every C program starts with header files. Okay. The structure of C program consists of header files, then all the global variable declaration, main program, and later on the function definition. Okay. So we have seen that structure in our first lecture. So here hash include stdio.h and conio.h are the header files required for input output statements in C programming language. STDIO stands for standard, I is input and O is output. Standard input output dot h header file, which consists of all the input output related functions like printf and scanf. We have another header file, that is conio dot h, conio dot h, console input output header file, which stores the function information like clear screen, get ch, that we require for formatting our output data display. Every C program execution starts from the main program. So this is our main program, and inside this main program, inside this opening and closing bracket, whatever the code that we write is considered as a block of code. A block in C program is represented by opening and closing bracket, and there may be n number of lines of code in between that block. Okay, so here these opening bracket, curly bracket indicates the start of the main program, and this closing bracket indicates the end of the main program. Okay, the first line into the main program that I have written is clear screen. I have used the function, inbuilt function clear screen, which first of all creates clears the screen before printing any message from the current program. So it first clears the screen. Second line written here is to print the hello message. So we use the printf statement. In double quotes we have written slash n slash t and then a message hello, double quote close, semicolon, closing the bracket and semicolon. It indicates that the slash n means print the output hello on the next line after a certain tab space, one tab space. Okay, it print the message hello on the screen. And the last line into this program is getch. It is responsible for holding the output somewhere on the screen. If you are using a Turbo C compiler, say, and if you run this same program, it will display the message hello on the output screen and holds the output till you press the next key button, right? Any key if you press, it comes back to the original program. Now we will see what happens if you do not write getch here. If you do not write getch, say, then it will not hold the output on the screen. It will print the output and immediately within fraction of a second it comes back to the original screen. If you are using a Turbo C compiler, say. Okay. So there is a possibility that you are not able to view the output properly. So to view that output properly, we must use this getch function to hold the output somewhere on the screen, and whenever you press any key on the keyboard, the program should come to the original screen. Okay. So the output of the program will come on the screen like this. Hello. Okay. Now we'll see the second program, that is to perform addition of two numbers and display the sum on the screen. In the first program, we studied only about C inputs, the output statement, that is printf statement. Now in the next program, we are going to study both the functions printf and use of both the functions printf and scanf. The program is to read any two random numbers from the users and display the sum on the screen. Again, we will start the program with the two lines, that is hash include stdio.h and hash include conio.h. We start our main program like this, void main, opening bracket. In this program, we need how many variables? We need two input variables and one variable to store the output. So there are altogether three variables in this program, A, B and C of integer type. This will clear the screen before printing any message from this program. So it means the output of our program will come on the fresh screen. Then we will prompt a message to the user for entering the values of variable A and B like this with the help of this printf line. Then in the next line, with the help of scanf, we want to read the values into A and B variable. So this line is responsible for taking the input from the user and placing it in that values into variable A and variable B. So the first percentage D written here in scanf statement tells the compiler that read the value and store it at the address of variable A. Read the second value, store it at the address of variable B. So at the end of this scanf statement, you will find the values are assigned to variable A and B in the computer's memory. So this is the input process of this program. Second step in the program is processing statements. So I want to perform the addition. So what would be the process for it? I need to write a formula, correct? C equals to A plus B is the mathematical expression which actually calculates the addition of two numbers and store the result into the left hand side variable C. So here A and B variable values gets added and the result gets stored into variable C. Now what is remaining in the program is third step, that is output. So every program has three steps: input, process and output. So we did input, we did process and the third step is output. So we use the printf statement like this to print the value of the variable C, that is our sum. Sum equal to percentage D and it is stored in variable C. So we write variable C here. So this printf line will going to display the addition of two numbers and get CH at last to terminate the program. And this is the closing bracket of the program. So when you execute this program, compile and execute the program on the Turbo C compiler, you will find the first message on the screen that is prompting the user to enter the value of variable A and B. A cursor will be here. So suppose you entered value 10, then give a space and enter value 20. When you press enter after this line, you will find the output automatically on the screen, that is sum equal to 30, which is the effect of the output statement here in this program. So this ends your second program where we learn about both input as well as output statement, how to use input and output statement in the C program. In our third program, we are going to study about how to calculate the simple interest. How to calculate simple interest. And we all know the formula to calculate the simple interest, that is SI, is the simple interest equal to P into N into R divided by 100. P is the principal, N is the number of years, R is the rate of interest in this simple interest calculation. Now to solve this program, I must have four different variable declarations. Four variables, that is P, N, R, which hold the input values for principal, number of years and rate of interest. And there is another variable SI that is called output variable, three input variable and one output variable SI to store the result and display it on the screen. Okay. Now we'll write the code for finding the simple interest. Check the code here. The standard header files will write here, standard input output header file and then console input output header file. Then main program like the previous programs. Opening and closing bracket of the program consists of the actual code of the program. So first of all, we'll declare all the four variables that we need into this program. That is P, N, R, SI. All are declared as float because the result is probably going to come into float only. Clear screen will clear the screen. This line will come on a fresh screen. Printf, enter the values of P, N and R. So here in this line, we are taking the input values for input variables P, N and R. P is for principal amount, n is the number of year, r is the rate of interest. In the next line of scanf, we are going to read the values. All the variables are of float type, that's why the format specifier in this program we need is %f, because f is the format specifier, %f is the format specifier for float variables. So we need three different variable values of float. So we need 3% f here in the double quotes, comma, then we read the first value into ampersand p, second ampersand n, and third is ampersand n. The first value goes into principal, second value goes into number of years n, and third value goes into rate of interest r. Consider that the input is over. Now the next step in the program is process. To process the simple interest, I must write a formula to calculate the simple interest like this: SI equal to in bracket p into a into r. So the product of all the three variables will be taken, and at last we will divide that product by 100 to get the simple interest. So p into n into r divided by 100 is the formula to find the simple interest. Now assume that the operation is successfully done, and the last step is to display the output. Here the next line we are going to display the simple interest, which is stored into SI variable on the script. So this gets used, will terminate the program here. Closing bracket is the end of the program. Now one more program we are going to see, that is to swap two numbers without using third variable. I want to swap two numbers without using third variable. So we'll use the first three line as it is, like the previous program, that is hash into str.h, conio.h, and void main opening bracket. Here we need three variables into this program, two input variable and third variable which we are going to use for swapping two numbers. So a and b are input variables in this case. So here we are asking the user to enter the values of the variables a and b with the help of this printf line. Scanf line is responsible for reading the values of a and b here. Consider the input that given by the user is say 10 and 20. Before swapping the logic, if I use the logic of swapping, I want to print the values say of a and b variable. So what would be the result of before swapping? Before swapping, a equal to %d, b equal to %d, and we are displaying a and b value here. So before swapping, it will be going to display a value as 10 and b value as 20 in this program. Now this is a three line code which actually swap the values of variable a and b. The first line in this logic or processing logic is temp equal to a. It means we are assigning the value whatever may be in variable a into temporary variable. That's why a becomes 10. Assume that a value is 10 and b value is 20. So temp becomes 10. Then we are assigning the value of b to variable a. It means a equal to b. Here a becomes 20. And in the last line, we are writing b equal to temp. It means the previous value of temp now gets stored into variable b. So b value becomes 10, because in previous first line temp was 10. So 10 gets stored into b. Now if you see, the input provided by us was a equal to 10 and b equal to 20 in the previous line, and at the end of this b equal to temp line, if we check the values of a and b, the a is now, current value of a is 20 and current value of b is 10. It means the values gets swapped. Now if you try to print the values of variable a and b, current values of a and b, you will find the values gets swapped. So we will use this line printf after swap, a equal to %d, b equal to %d. Here we are mentioned a and b, it means it is going to display the value of variable a and b, current values of a and b. It says, and this closing bracket will terminate the program. So if you see the output on the screen, you will first find the line that is enter the values of a and b. Here you have to enter the values by giving space, 10 space 20. So a goes to 10, sorry, 10 goes to a and 20 goes to b. And before swap, you will find value of a is 10, value of b is 20. And after swapping, a value becomes 20 and b value becomes 10. So this ends your fourth program. If you have any doubt, you can ask me into the chat room. Okay, there are no doubts. Thank you for watching the video.